We were talking about this yesterday. Celine Dion is retiring.
Stop. Don't even talk about it, Opie. I get all choked up.
Yes, Celine.
Which is a complete joke. She's going to go away for 2 years, and then she's going to come back. She's going to be bigger and better than ever for all those fat housewives.
Her big comeback.
She'll have her big comeback. She's not retiring forever. She's too young. There's nothing else she's going to do.
No.
She's going to try to start a family.
Yeah, she'll be back.
So Oprah Winfrey made a huge deal about this.
Oh, stop.
Was it yesterday? On yesterday's show, they had Celine Dion.
Oh. I hate this song, man.
This is dedicated to the people of the Titanic. All of those who perished. I see waters of the North Atlantic. I send this song out to all the people and to the survivors. Those who were able to live on with their lives after the great ship went down.
You stole another bit from me, you bastard.
Yeah, that's Opie's bad. I'm sorry.
I don't do many. Come on.
The brave people that could survive the icy waters of the North Atlantic in their boats watching the mighty Titanic slowly slip beneath the surface of the water. This song goes out to them. The survivors.
Anyway. But she sings perfectly.
What a tool.
Her voice is all effed up, but she sings perfectly.
Yeah.
Perfect English.
Listen to her.
Anyway, do we have the letter from the Oprah Winfrey Show?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Yeah, where is it? Please.
So here it is. It was a tear fest on Oprah yesterday.
Yeah.
And they read this letter from this guy. Well, we're going to mock this guy. So I want to say in advance that he's okay now.
Yeah, he's okay. It's just, I mean, I don't care what you got. I'm sorry about that, but you sound like the biggest pussy in the world.
This guy does sound like the biggest pussy in the world. And during the cry fest, they had this guy read his letter that he sent to Celine.
We've received a lot of mail from viewers who've been moved by Celine's music. Brian Kluse was watching our show the last time Celine was here and wrote us this letter. Take a look.
Dear Oprah, I'm sitting in my hospital room going through a bone marrow transplant for lymphoma. I'm a grown man crying after watching Celine Dion sing the theme to Titanic on your show. About Celine in one of your previous shows and fell in love with her music, voice, and great attitude for life and family.
And camel toe.
At that time, I was just diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma.
Ow.
Hearing Celine sing some of her songs had me bawling. Her song, Because You Love Me, couldn't have hit home more perfectly about the way I feel about my wife, Kathy.
Listening to the song, wasn't sure where my future was going, how I was going to survive the cancer and fight it and things like that. It just really hit home.
After the show, I went right out and bought the CD and gave it to my wife. To this day, Kathy and I can't listen to the song, Because You Love Me, without crying. A strong, loving woman, a special lady in my life. My heart and soul. Couldn't imagine a day without her. She's everything to me.
Brian and Kathy, we thought your letter was sweet. We wanted to do something special for you. So, you're going to her final performance.
Listen to Oprah.
I am so happy for you guys. You're going to be there for the final floor.
Unbelievable.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
I gotta jump in here. God forbid I was, you know, had a cancer scare, Anthony.
God forbid, really.
And, you know, like this guy, he decided he needs to go see Celine Dion.
Yeah.
Know what would be better than that? Being able to watch Oprah at Sunday brunch.
Yeah, that's what you want to see.
Oh, and if I had my choice, Anthony, went through all the chemo, you know, my hair's in patches all over my head.
Oh.
Am I going to see Celine Dion sing the Titanic song? No, I want to see Oprah Winfrey at Sunday brunch. That's when I know Oprah cares.
I want to see Celine.
Jesus. Oh, more Celine. I don't want...
She's sensitive.
I want to be home and do some cooking and stay home and have no schedule and no pressure and say, let's go for a picnic and drive my own car and pick my own tomatoes.
My own tomatoes and give myself a frontal wedgie every day. Looks like I have ass in the front.
Buy some new yo-yos for the front of my pants.
My pants sink deeper than the Titanic in the front. A crevice in the front when I wear my jump pants that is deeper than the crevice made by the iceberg in the mighty bow of the Titanic. It actually looks like I was straddling the iceberg and the bow of the Titanic struck me right in my camel toe. That's what made this big gummy when I wear my tight jumpsuit. You see my tight jumpsuit? And my pelvis bones that jet out. I am the iceberg. The Titanic slammed into my crotch at approximately 12 knots. The man in the crow's nest yelled, camel toe, dead ahead. But the mighty Titanic could not stop. It hit my groin at 12 knots, ripping open many watertight compartments and leaving me with a hatchet wound unlike no other. This goes out to the survivors who, before they sank, before they got into the lifeboats, were able to take one last look in the lights of the distress flares and see my camel toe. The camel toe that brought down the mighty Titanic on her maiden voyage. Can you believe it? Who thought a gas could bring down a mighty ocean liner like the Titanic? They called it unsinkable.
Celine, how many people lost their lives in your crotch?
I believe it was 750 people died. Because of my camel toe. If you look, some nights when I am in concert with my tight jumpsuit, you can see on each thigh HMS Titanic and anchor wounds.
Now I know why Leonardo DiCaprio's face was blue.
It was from the smell.
Hold on, Jack!
The ship got unsinkable and iceberg proof. Not to be camel toe proof. The yo-yo I smuggled could take down the Queen Mary. But that goes out to the survivors. Those who were able to live on and make their dreams come true. And get the nightmarish image of my groin out of their head forever. I'm quitting show business.
Fred.
Anthony has a serious future as a Celine Dion impersonator. When you say the word survivor.
This song is dedicated to the Titanic and its fearless crew and passengers. Not just those that perished in the icy waters of the North Atlantic, but also to the survivors.
Excellent.
All right, Fred. That's funny. God damn it, that's funny, man. I don't even care if anyone else is laughing. That's some top shelf stuff right there.
Oh, yeah.
That's where it's at. That is just. All right, because of that Celine Dion bit,
yes,
that went on for 20 minutes. We have to go to commercials again.
A commercial break.
We apologize.
I am not going to sing anymore. Opie, Anthony, if I may just cut in for a moment.
Yeah.
Of course, you know I am ending my singing career.
Yeah.
I have made people very happy with my voice, but I am stopping for a time so I may do other things. These things that I am doing will help people also. I am going to be hired by the National Baseball Association.
Oh, yeah? Why?
Yes. Baseball will need me to model the new catcher's mitt out of my private area. Because it looks like I have a catcher's mitt down the front of my jumpsuit. And, of course, look for me at high schools as the bicycle rack. I will be appearing on the next Fox special with Robbie Knievel.
Oh, really?
Yes, he is going to jump my mighty hatchet wound. You've seen him many times try to jump school buses and whatnot.
Yeah.
This is the most dangerous jump of them all.
I believe it would be a brand new world record.
Yes, from labia to labia.
Okay, thank you.
Very difficult.
All right, thank you, Celine.
And I will be doing a new movie.
A new movie, huh?
Yes.
Yeah.
Celine will be in the new Batman movie.
Oh, yeah?
My genitals will be the new Batcave.
Shut up! Turn it off! Oh,